Is it audible to you, sir?
Okay. So, good morning, students. Let me introduce Professor Om Prakash Bardhan. He was my colleague at Department of Electrical Engineering. And he is pursuing his research in thermal engineering at Gulbarga. And from what he does, he has been teaching the subject at सरांची का एक्सपर्टीज आहे हायड्रोलिक्स आणि न्यूमॅटिक्स. तर आपण त्यांना चार्ज दिले.
गुड मॉर्निंग
सर. गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
व्हेरी गुड मॉर्निंग. हाउ आर यू फ्रेंड्स?
बाय.
Sir, it's not at all visible to me, any other students or any other this one.
Hello.
Hello, sir. You are not at all visible to me, sir.
Okay, that's not an issue.
Okay.
To...
Okay, sir. Very good morning. Myself Om Prakash Siddharam Bardhan. I'm natively from Karnataka. Okay, I'm little bit not good at Marathi language. I can understand the Marathi language, but I didn't speak fluently the Marathi language. Okay, by my profitolio, I'm teaching this subject from past 5 years, the hydraulics and pneumatics. Okay. And also I accessed more than 1,000 papers for this hydraulics and pneumatics papers. Okay, so the thing is, next comes, so I'm now engaging the last unit for you guys, the sixth unit. Okay, I think you guys all have the PPT one. Okay, do you have the PPT with you guys? Okay, sir. Oh. Okay, sir. Not an issue, sir. Okay.
We have it, but we can't open it on.
Same. Other. Ha. Yes. Himamshu. Yes. Very good. Not an issue. Okay. So you guys all know it. What do you mean by hydraulics and pneumatics? So hydraulics is nothing but we are going to use the pressurized fluid as a working media, but in pneumatics we are going to use the compressed air. Okay, so whenever the external or wherever you go in the interview or whenever they ask what is the media in a pneumatics, means you have to say compressed air. Okay, so you have to say the compressed air. So this is all about the basics, and you guys all know it already, what is the difference between or what are the advantages or disadvantages of the hydraulics and pneumatics. Okay, today we are going to discuss, so how we are going to design a hydraulic or pneumatic component. For your syllabus there is only hydraulics one. Okay, so I'm going to first elaborate the how we are going to design a system design hydraulic system. Okay, at first what they are going to do, they are going to give a problem of the statement of the problem, something like that. Okay, they are going to say that for example, there is a piston is there. Okay, so it has to carry a load of, consider 10 kilo Newton. Okay, and it has to move at a rate of some x minute or x seconds. Okay, from that one you have to design. Then next thing he is going to go some effective load. So from 10 kilonewton to, it is maybe raised to 20 kilonewton or 30 kilonewton. Okay. So like this, it is going to be shown. So for that one, you have to say, so what it is going to be there. So next one is, so from that one, what they are going to give apart from that one, they are going to give the components like tank. So 3 to 4 tank components will be there. Okay, then filter will be there, pump will be there, pressure relief valve will be there, a DCV will be there, check valve will be there. Like that, they are going to give the list of components with various ratings for that one. For tank, you may consider for 10 liters, 20 liters, 30 liters, 100 liters, depending upon your application, what kind of the problem statement is there. So you have to give. Okay. Next comes. Okay. I will going to read one problem for you guys. Okay. First understand the problem. So what they have given for you guys, then try to solve. Okay. Now I'm going to read the first problem for you. One second. See here what they have given. A machine slide is moved by means of hydraulic cylinder. Okay. The motion of the cylinder is as follows. Okay. There is a machine slide is there. Okay. So consider this as a slide. Okay. So it has to move. Next. Initially, it moves through a distance of 200 millimeter against a load of 12 kilonewton in 3 seconds. Okay. So this is the slide. So consider that the empty weight, or there is no load in this on slide. So what is the weight of this one now? So the weight is 12 kilonewton. So what it has to move? It has to move a 200 millimeter. So in what time period it has to cover with a weight of 12 kilonewton in 3 seconds. Okay. So 200 millimeter in 3 seconds of a load 12 kilonewton. Okay, next. It is followed by the working stroke of 100 mm against an effective load of 35 kilonewton. Okay, so what it is now? It is followed by the working stroke of 100 mm. So at first it has moved 200 mm. Now it has to move 100 mm with an effective load of 35 kilonewton. At first it is 12 kilonewton. Now they have been increased or put a load of 23 kilonewton. Okay, in the next line they are going given the feed rate, that is at what period it has to move. So the feed rate during this part of the stroke is required to be between 0.5 to 1 meter per minute. Okay, so see here, it has been reduced. Since the load has been increased, the speed has been reduced now. Okay, next, use the regeneration for retraction. So what they have told now, so you have to use the retraction, okay? You have to use the retraction circuit for this one. You have to use the retraction circuit. I guys know you retraction. What do you mean by retraction? Himamshu, can you answer?
Returning.
Regeneration for retraction. What it means? Yes. Okay. So whenever the retraction is going to take place, which is going from the piston end. Okay. The piston end oil, it is a bit of pressurized one. So we are going to use that one for again moving for the piston inside for the extension. Are you guys getting now? So while retraction, okay, whatever the oil is coming out from the piston inside, again it is sent back into for the retraction. Okay, so a bit of pressure is increased without using the any extra power or so hence the efficiency will be increased. Next, mid-train circuit is used for the speed control. I think this one is also, you guys know it, mid-train circuit. What do you mean by mid-train circuit? So what is the purpose of metering circuit? Yes, very good. For speed control, okay. For speed control, you have to use the metering circuit. But for where? For the extension or retraction? For we can use for the both. Okay, it is used for the both the purpose, for the while extension or for retraction. But you have to take care of that. This one, the fluid is entering. So meter in means while entering, we are going to control the velocity. Okay, the velocity of the fluid which is flowing into the cylinder. It may be on the extension or it may be for the retraction. Okay, so like that, we are going to use the metering circuit. Now, next line. Draw and design the hydraulic circuit mentioned in the selection requirements for flow control valve. Okay, relief valve, pump valve, strainer and reservoir. Okay, so like that they have been told. So what we have to do, so what at first what they have given now is 200 meter against a load of 12 kilo Newton in 3 seconds. Okay, next it is followed by the working stroke of 100 mm against an effective load of 35 kilo Newton. Okay, the feed rate during this part is 0.5 meter per minute or 1 meter per minute. Now what we have to do, we have to calculate the what is the velocity in a uniform dimension, like a meter per second or meter per minute or meter per hour. So whichever is suitable for us. So we have to calculate the velocity while extension, while retraction. Okay, because they have given two. Okay, that is for the extension, they have the two parts. That is for 12 kilonewton in 3 seconds. Next one is 35 kilonewton at a speed of 0.5 or 1 meter per minute. Okay, now what we have considered for the first one, extension one, 0.2 divided by 3. So why we have taken 0.2? Because there is a 200 mm is there and we have to cover this one in 3 seconds. Okay, that's why we are going to get the velocity for the extension is 0.067 meter per second. Okay, now what we have to do, again we have to calculate for the extension, there is a another part, that is 35 kilonewton is there. The for that one, it has to cover a 100 mm in 0.5 to 1 meter per minute. So we are going to divide now. They have directly given meter per second. For the extension one, that is 0.2 divided by 3, we have been done. So we are going to get 0.067 meter per second. Now for the extension two, the velocity will be, that is 0.0167 meter per second. From this one, we can say that while extension in a first part, that is carrying a 12 kilonewton, it is much faster than while carrying the load 35 kilonewton for the 100 millimeter. Okay, now what we have to do next, we have to calculate the cylinder area or the diameters of the cylinder. Okay, so this is how we are going to calculate. Means at first we have to consider the AFIU cylinder, which is the highest piston diameter or bore diameter, or you can say rod diameter. So again, sir, how can we consider at the biggest one? So whatever the pressure is developed, if you are going to consider a small diameter with having less bore or piston diameter, okay, so the pressure developed will be more and it has the more chances of getting burst. For that one, what we are going to do, we have to consider for the maximum bore or piston cylinder. So again, it depends upon, now you are at a student level, so there is no space consideration for you guys. So when you are going to enter into the industry, the space constraint will be come. So they are going to say that, so this is the area available for that one. So you have to consider this much of bore or piston diameter or rod diameter. So for that one, at the time, you are going to consider one by one by using trial and error methods. Okay. So since the space constraint is not there for us at present, okay, we are going to consider the maximum one. Okay. We are going to consider the maximum one. the maximum one, that is the diameter given is 100 mm, the bore diameter given is 100 mm and the rod diameter is 50 mm. Okay, the next one is, so what we are going to do, now we are going to calculate the pressure. So what do you mean by pressure? What do you mean by pressure? Rohit Pawar? Himanshu Chauhan? Okay, I'm going to tell, it is nothing but the force upon the area. Okay, so what is the force? So now we are going to consider the first part, that is initially it moves through a distance of 200 mm against the load of 12 kN in 3 seconds. That is, what is the force now? The force is 12,000 divided by area. Area of which one we have to consider now? So we have to consider the bore diameter or piston diameter, which is of 100 mm. Okay, so it is 100 mm. That is pi by 4 d square. So d square is 0.1 square. So when you are going to calculate this one, we are going to get the pressure developed in that cylinder while moving a 12 kilonewton of bore dia 100 mm is 15.27 bar. Okay, so how much we got now? 15.27 bar. Now we have to calculate the flow rate. We have to calculate the flow rate now. So how we are going to calculate the flow rate? Okay, Q is equal to AV. You guys know it. Q is equal to AV.
Yes,
so A, we know it. That is pi by 4 D square. That is the diameter which we have chosen. The model is A5, which is having the bore or piston diameter of 100 mm. So pi by 4 0.1 square into V. So where we got the V? 0.067. That is, we have been done this one, 0.2 divided by 3. So we got the 0.067 meter per second of speed. So when we multiply this one, we are going to get the flow rate of 5.26 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per second. So how much we are going to get? We are going to get the 5.26 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per second. So can you, someone can convert this one, the 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per second into LPM. You guys know what you mean by LPM? Yes, very good guys, very good guys. Huh? Liter per minute. So how can we convert 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per second into LPM?
1000.
Yes, very good. So it is in a seconds, na? So what we got? Meter cube per second we got. Now what we have to convert that one into liter per minute. For that one, what we have to do? You have to multiply it by 60 into 10 raised to 3. Okay, 1000 is very good, very correct answer. But since we are converting that one into LPM, liter per minute, if it is LPS, liter per second, then you can just simply multiply by 1000, okay, or 10 raised to 3, you are going to get LPS, since we are going to convert this one into liter per minute. Why we have to convert this liter per minute means the whatever the ratings are given, so those are all things in terms of LPM. So that's why we have to multiply that one into 60 into 10 raised to 3 LPM. Okay, so 5.26 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per second is multiplied with the 60 into 10 raised to 3 for the conversion of meter cube second into liter per minute. Okay, so we are going to get the 31.55 LPM. Okay, so how, by, for which one we got this one? So this is, we got, so this is, we got it for carrying a load of 12 kilonewton, okay, of a 200 mm in 3 seconds, okay, for 3 seconds. Now, what we have to calculate, next one, we have to calculate a 100 meter is travel, millimeter is traveled, an effective load of 12 kilonewton at a rate or at a feed rate of 0.5 to 1 meter per minute. So while doing this one, again, what we have to do, P is equal to F upon A, force upon area. Okay. So force is again 35 kilonewton, that is 35,000, divided by area pi by 4 d square. D square is nothing but 100 mm, that is 0.1 meter square now. So whenever we are going to convert this one, we are going to get the P as 44.56 bar, that is 44.56 bar we are going to get. In the first one, for a load of 12 kilonewton, we got it as 15.27 bar, and a flow rate of 31.55 lpm. Now for the second part, that is 35 kilonewton, for a distance of 100 millimeter at a rate of 1 meter per minute, we got it as a pressure 44.56. So what is this 44.56? So this is the maximum pressure developed in the cylinder while carrying a 35 kilonewton of effective load at a speed of 1 meter per minute. You guys got it? So this is the maximum pressure will be developed in the system, that is, that the system means in the cylinder. Okay, now we have to calculate the flow rate. Now, while calculating the flow rate, Q is equal to again A into V. Now, area will be same, that is pi d square by 4. But V, which we have to take is 1 meter per minute. So again, what we have to do? Again, we have to convert that one into second, or you can just simply keep it as a minute. So we are going to get the LPM. Okay, since the ratings are given in terms of LPM, so you it's your choice whether you have to convert that one into meter, that is meter per minute, or meter per second. Okay, so we will convert into second. Okay, so we are already converted that one into second, that is 0.067. So 1 divided by 60, that is meter per minute, which they have given in the statement. Again, we have divided by, that is 1 divided by 60. What we are going to get, that is 0.0167. meter per second we are going to get. The area is same, that is pi d square by 4. So d is nothing but 0.1 square. So after doing the calculation, so we are going to get the Q, that is flow rate, as 7.87 lpm. okay, 7.87 lpm we are going to get. So now from this one, we can say that the pressure developed for the first part is 15.27 bar, and the flow rate, that is discharge, is 31.55 lpm. Next, for the second part, that is for 35 kilonewton, we got it as 44.56 bar as a pressure, and the flow rate is 7.87 lpm. Okay, next. Next one is calculations for the return stroke. They have not said anything about the retraction. They have not given any load for that one. So we are going to assume, that is, Q retraction is equal to AP minus AR. So why we have to do this one? Because while retraction, the rod will be come into the picture. So the area of the piston minus the area of the rod into velocity. So we have to calculate the velocity, and also we already know that what is the maximum flow rate, that is 31.55 lpm, which is we got for the 12 kilo newton load. Now retraction, QV retraction, we are going to get 0.0893 meter per second. Okay, so that is, that one will be covered, the retraction will be covered it in a time period of 3.35 seconds will be covered. Okay, now next comes, so what is the maximum working pressure? So why we have to calculate this one? So whatever the components, like oil reservoir, suction strainer, pump, directional control valve, pressure relief valve, flow control valve, or cylinder, all they are going to give in terms of the maximum pressure developed in the system, or the maximum flow rate, what you call it as, created while moving an load. Okay, so first we are going to calculate, we are going to know that the maximum working pressure. So what is the maximum working pressure? Is 44.56 bar for a carrying load of 35 kilonewton. Okay, so it is obvious. So whenever the load is maximum, the pressure will be developed, the pressure created or developed will be more. So next, maximum flow rate. So we can, so can anyone say, so when will be the maximum flow rate will be developed? Himanshu? Rohit? Well, yes, very good. Pressure will be reduced. See here, how much for we pressure will be reduced for the first part. Okay, so next one is, so where will be the maximum flow rate will be developed? Rohit Pawar? Okay, I'm going to tell the answer for you guys. Okay, the maximum flow rate will be developed for the first load, that is for carrying the 12 kilonewton. So just assume that you are carrying a 1 kilo of load or 1 kilonewton of load, and I am going to say that you just run for a 100 meter. So you are going to run very fast. Now I am going to give a 10 kilonewton of load, and I am going to say that run for the same 100 meter. So which one will be the faster? So while carrying the 1 kilonewton, so you are going to run very faster. So while carrying the 10 kilonewton, the load will be more, the so hence the pressure is more, and whatever you call that, for that one, the for that one, the maximum flow rate, that is your running, will be less. While carrying the less load, the pressure will be low, but the flow rate, that is the running, the speed will be more. Okay, from that one we can say that, okay, the maximum flow rate developed will be 31.55 lpm, and the maximum load will be 44.56 bar. Okay, now what we have to choose, now we have to choose the components, we have to choose the components. Oil reservoir, so that is will be multiplied with the whatever the maximum flow rate we got. So the maximum flow rate we got is 31.55 lpm into 3. Okay, while we multiplying 31.55, which is the maximum flow rate, with the 3, the 3 is the constant, we have to take it as a constant 3. So we are going to get as 94.65 liter. Okay, from the given table. So the table or the model will be given in the question paper itself. You should not carry to the examination hall. Within the question paper, in the last page, they are going to give the all the data for which is required for the system design. Okay, so 95. So while doing the 95, okay, so you can see here, I'm going to show you. Okay, one second. Pressure gauge selection of pump. Okay. So you can see here. So here is the oil reservoir. Can you see this one, Himanshu?
Yes, sir, there is some technical problem.
Sorry? So you can see here, they have given the oil reservoir in terms of, okay, T1 as 40 liter, okay, T2 as 100 liter, T3 as 250 liter, T4 as 400 liter, T5 as 600 liters. Okay, so from this one we can say, so how much we got? We got it as a 95 liter. So 95 liter is nearer and greater than T2. Okay, so T2 is 100 liter. We can directly choose it as T2 for a 100 liter. Okay, so this completes your oil reservoir. Next one, what we have to consider? We have to consider the suction strainer. Suction strainer. So what do you mean by suction strainer? I am again going to show you in a book suction strainer. So suction strainer is nothing but, one second. Okay, here is the suction strainer, you guys. Okay, I think it will be is visible for you guys. S1 is 38 liter, S2 is 76 liter, S3 is 152 liters. Okay, while selecting this one, so how much we have got it? How much we got is S1 we can easily consider because how much we got, the maximum flow rate is 31.55. And the given one is 38 here. So we can easily and defaultly we are going to consider the S1. Next comes the pump P1. So the one of the thing is you have to consider the pump is you have to very carefully you have to consider. You can see here in the question paper they are given in like this. P1 is equal to 65. The pressure also they given and also they given the delivery also. Okay, they also given the delivery as well as the delivery is nothing but the flow rate meter cube per second. They have given pressure in terms of bar. So what is the maximum pressure we have achieved is 44.56 bar. For that one we can easily consider the P1. Okay, now whether we can consider the this one what flow rate. So for the flow rate purpose, okay, so here is the LPM in terms of the LPM. So you can see here, so for the zero bar, there are totally five models are there. Okay, for 35 bar, again 5 and 70 bar. So what is the maximum pressure we have developed is, okay, 31. So what is the, here it is there any 31 here? No, up to P4, there is maximum pressure developed will be, okay, is 8.5 bar like this only we have been developed. That is for 35 bar. What is the maximum flow rate is 11.5 and 9.5. Okay, so we have achieved 31. So we have to consider for that one P5. Okay, before P5 up to P4 or from P1 to P4, we have not achieved any 31 LPM. Okay, so that's why we have to consider the P5. Okay, next comes after completing this one, we have to choose the directional control valve. Again, you have to consider consider the maximum pressure is 44.56 bar and the maximum flow rate is 31.55 LPM. For that one, D3, similarly, you can go through the pressure relief valve, okay, then flow control valve and cylinder, which we have already considered in the first model itself, or while selecting the finding the maximum flow rate and for the maximum pressure developed in the system. Okay, and like
sir, these questions are present in that PDF which sir has given to us.
Yes, it will be there. It will be there. But you better to ask Deshpande sir.
What sir?
The sir is going to give the whatever the the notes will be given by the sir. Otherwise, I am going to share with the sir. Sir will privately send you or in your WhatsApp group. They are going to share.
Okay.
So this completes your one of the. If you have any doubts, please ask me. And it is asked for 12 to 16 marks, and depend upon the what you want to call it as a difficulty level. Okay, for the circuit, they are going to ask for 6 to 8 marks. And while writing this description, so yeah, they are going to allow you for 8 to 10 marks. So totally 16 marks, up to 16 marks, they are going to ask from 12 to 16 marks.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Thanks.
Thank you, sir. It's again.
Distance learning program.
the technology connects all. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Welcome. Yes. Okay. Bye, sir. Bye.